Hello folks, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to set up custom document templates for Microsoft Teams. So stay tuned and let's go to the demo after this short intro. For instance, if you have a Microsoft Teams and you want custom document templates to use under the File tab, when a team member creates a document, he or she should be able to select a predefined template to fill in the information. In this example, I will configure custom invoice template for the Teams File tab. I have a project Contoso here, and under this project, I have a journal channel and raise invoices channel. So under this raise invoices channel, if I go to the Files tab, I can see this default template here. If I click on this new dropdown, I can see Word, Excel, PowerPoint, OneNote, or form for Excel. Now I want a custom invoice template to be displayed here as an option as a template. So if I quickly show you the invoice template, so this is the invoice template I want to put in. So when someone click on new, it should be selecting this invoice so a person can fill in the information and save the document. So to do that, I need to make some changes into SharePoint document library, which is hosting this Raise Invoices channel. So if I click on this open in SharePoint link, this will open this document library inside the SharePoint. From the top right setting icon, I will click on library settings. I need to go to advanced settings, and then I need to allow management of content type to yes, and then I will click OK. Now, the next thing I need to do is I need to create a content type. So by default, there is a document content type here. I can add an existing content type, but I cannot create a content type here. So I need to go back to the setting gear icon, go to site settings, and here under web design galleries, I can see site content type. So I will click on that, and then I will click on create. So this is the content type which will host this custom template. So I will call it invoice. And it will be a document content type, and the parent content type is going to be a document, and I will add it under the custom content type. Click OK. Now the content type is ready, so I will go back to the documents library from the left hand menu, so I can see all those channels folders here. Now if I go to this library, if I go to library settings, and if I click on add from existing site content type, now if I select from this option custom content type, and there is only one, I will add that in the invoice content type which we just created. Okay, now the content type is added. Now the next thing is that I need to apply that Word template to this content type. So if I click on this invoice content type from the list settings page, and then if I go to advanced settings, here it has a default template. I can upload a new template, so I will check upload a new template document and click on choose file. I need to navigate to a folder where the invoice template exists, so I will select the invoice template, click open, and then click OK. So this will apply that custom invoice template to this content type, and we have already added this content type to this document library definition. So if I go back to the documents, now if I click on new here, you can see there is a default document content type, and there is also an invoice content type listed here. Now if I go back to Microsoft Teams, and if I just refresh the page and go to the Files tab under one of the channel and click on new, here I can see the invoice template is available to use. So if I click on that, it will ask me to give a name for this invoice. So I will just call it 0001 and click create. Now you can see that it is bringing the invoice template here, where I can change the name, person, and all the other relevant information, who is shipped to, and what product you're delivering, product description, and all that kind of stuff. And if I just say total 100, for example, so you can fill this information on this invoice, add a logo. So this is a predefined template which the other members in your team can use to save some time and quickly fill in all the invoices. So once you're done with it, you can just go back. It will save it in real time. So the first invoice template is already saved. If I click on this one again, now you can see the information which I put in is saved already. And if I go back to the journal channel, because this template is applied on the document library level, it does not matter which channel I go to, I will see the content type under the file tabs of every channel. So if I go to journal channel, I can see the invoice template listed here. So to just wrap up this video, today you have learned how to set up custom document templates for Microsoft Teams file tabs. Thank you for watching this video. Consider subscribing if you're new to the channel by pressing the red subscribe button below this video and click the notification bell icon so you don't miss any of my future videos as I upload new videos every week. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it useful. If you have any question regarding this topic or any other query related to Office 365, put in the comment section below. I review the comments on a daily basis. I will be happy to answer them. Thank you.